Hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BeauView Gaming, and today we are back in Hammerhelm. Yes, it is so exciting. We are going to be playing the 1.0 preview. The game has just been updated last night with what is pretty much a feature complete version of how the game will be when it leaves early access. Sometime in the near future, from what I've seen, there hasn't been any announcement about an exact release date. But of course, Jonathan, the developer, is gonna be tweaking the game a little bit and fixing any bugs that people report and things like that leading up to the release. And that's just so many changes, guys, which of course means that if you are returning to the game after having played in the past, you are gonna have to start a new game. But I think it's gonna be worth it with all these changes that have been made, right? And it is kind of expected when you play an early access game. But yeah, anyway, let's just get going, guys. I'm quite excited to check everything out because I haven't played the experimental. There's been an experimental version that people have been playing and keep giving feedback on and things, but I've kind of just kept tabs on the game via screenshots and skimming a few of these experimental patch notes and things, but I definitely haven't seen everything there, and I haven't actually played it myself. So this is going to be exciting, and I probably can't even remember half of what I have read, but let's just jump into this. So we are going to start a new character, and of course for those of you who might not know the game, you can play as a male or a female dwarf here, and I'm going to go with a female. Then we can change our skin color, lots of different options here. I tend to like to go for something that looks a little bit tanned, and then we can change our tunic color. And let's see, what are we going to go with this time? Maybe the green one, let's do that. And then, of course, you can change your hairstyle. Oh, it's the right click. Yes, yes, yes. Or you can use the arrow keys as well. So, there we go. We have a bunch of different hairstyles, as you can see. Look at that. Very, very nice. And we have this very long ponytail. Cool, cool, cool. And we have like a little bun here. Then we have this one, really, really gorgeous, actually. I really like that. And then we have this very cool one. And then we have a mohawk. Yep. And we have this, which I also really like, this short version. And then we have this one. Another cool short one. And then we are back to the beginning. So what am I going to go with? I think this time we're gonna go with this one. Yeah, let's do that. And then of course you can change your hair color as well. There's a few different options. I think I'm just gonna go with the red. And of course if you choose the male, you can have beard style and beard color as well. So create, and it is gonna be Freya because I really like that name. So confirm, and let's get into this. Ooh, and we definitely start out somewhere different. There's a little prologue that you play through before getting to where we used to start out, right? So, for as long as anyone can remember, the dwarves of the Hammerhelm clan have lived in their mountain stronghold. Centuries ago, Bulwar, the king of the dwarves, left on a secret mission to protect the stronghold. In his absence, a council was formed to rule. As the centuries passed and Bulwar did not return and resources began to become sparse, the clan fell into disarray. I think that should have been array. There's also a little typo up here, but I'm going to send the developer a screenshot. Deciding it was time for a drastic change, you proposed to the council leaving the stronghold and establishing a colony above ground. The council is making their decision today. Ooh. Okay. Wow, look at this. Definitely looks beautiful. I do like the graphics. Very cool. Nice. Okay. Let's have a little chat here with Drix, the weaponsmith. Thank goodness I found you, my friend. The council rejected your proposal to move above ground. Worse yet, they want to banish you. Oh no, what should I do? I don't think there's any benefit to staying. We should get you out of here. You'll be able to leave on your own terms and take some things with you. Oh, what about the others who wish to join us? They'll be fine. They still believe in your idea and are willing to make the trip once you have found a new suitable home. I left some equipment in the dining hall for you to take with you. Ooh, what about you? Will you be safe? Yes. The council isn't out for blood. They just don't think you're a good influence on the others. I'll stay behind and help those who wish to leave find their way to you. Cool. Okay, well, it's a good thing there's not gonna be some big fight to get out of here. Oh, wow, look at this. So cool. So, yeah, in the previous versions, you didn't really get any idea of all this because you pretty much started out already at the new home, right? But here you actually get this little prelogue, which I really, really like. So, we have this beautiful stronghold down here. Okay, so we have someone waiting over there. There's something up there. Let's try and check this out and see if we can find the dining hall. Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay, this looks promising. We have a lot of kegs, and then we have the dining hall. Awesome. I love all the little decor on the tables and things. So let's see what we find. Oh, we got some money, so that's very important. Then we got a simple hammer, basic shield, some weak heal potions, and some weak stamina potions. Okay, let's loot all. And then we're just immediately gonna remember to equip this. Let's put these up here. Let's just put you there. But good thing we also got some monies. Very nice. And then we need to speak with Callie the Miner again. It's interesting it says again, because I don't think we haven't talked with her before. We talked to the other guy, right? Okay, but it looks like we have to go there. Can we go up here? Is there anything here? No. That's probably where all the other dwarves are hanging out at the moment. Okay. So, let's see. Oh, cool. We have all kinds of oils there. Nice. Those weapons and potions should be enough to help you find a suitable place for us to live. I've placed a pickaxe and a hatchet in your backpack too. Ew, okay. If I remember correctly from last time I played so many games, so it's really hard to keep track sometimes and remember the differences from time to time, right? But if I remember correctly, that is actually a difference, because before you would just use your weapon when you needed to cut down trees or have a stone, right, or mine stone. Then you would just use whatever weapon you have, but now we actually get some tools, so that's different. Where is everyone? Everyone is still with the council. You're all clear. Where should I go next? Go through the doors behind me. These lead to an old mine. Take that to the surface and you should be able to find your way from there. Cool, thank you. Don't thank me. Just find a nice spot for us and I'll send others to you as you're ready for them. Cool. Awesome. Okay, let's just double check. I don't think we can... I think we still can't go up here, but I'm just curious before we leave this area. Nope. No. Not accessible. Okay. Well, then we are gonna head through the mines. Oh, wow. This is pretty. I like this. This cave is so cool. And let's see if it still works. If you press Ctrl-Alt-U, if I remember, yes, then you can actually hide the UI. And then, of course, use F12 if you're using Steam to take screenshots, or whatever you would use if you use some kind of other program for screenshots. But that is really handy to know if you're like me and you like taking some screenshots, right? There we go. And we can actually zoom in if we just wanted to have this, right? And we can do this. And there we go. Look at that. Beautiful. I love the design down here with this cave. There we go. But I kind of prefer playing like this so I can actually see what goes on, especially when we are going to get into some combat later. So, let's head through this place here. Oh, nice. Yeah, looks pretty. Okay. Doesn't look like there's anyone who's gonna be blocking our way out of here. We do have some crystals and stuff down here. Mm-hmm. Oh, let's see what awaits us. Ooh, a new home. Banished from your homeland for the rebellious act of suggesting dwarves could live above ground, you have spent months wandering and seeking new fertile lands to start your life in the open air. You have finally found such a spot, far enough away from the stronghold as to not anger your old clan, but close enough that your success will attract others who, like you, are tired of living underground. As you build the town, they will happily come seek you out and live in their new home. Cool. They are not the only ones watching, however. As your town grows in wealth, so will the threat from the goblins and orcs. They have already begun building small encampments to prepare to attack the first dwarves who aren't protected by the underground fortress. Ew. And this actually sounds a little bit like, if you don't know the game, it sounds a little bit like your town here that we are going to be building up is going to be attacked. But that's not the case, at least not, it's not going to be in this release version when the game gets released. But I know that other players have been suggesting that there should be like village raid where your village gets attacked, which I'm personally not a fan of. I hope if it's something that Jonathan decides to add in the future, that it will be a separate mode, because I like the game the way it is. It's very casual, instead of having to worry about someone coming and attacking your village. But it's all personal preference, right? Just to let you know that that is not the case in the current version of the game anyway. So, this is where we start out. Look at these gorgeous trees, and they're animated and everything. I didn't actually really look at the settings in, I usually do that, but since I played the game before, I forgot to do it. But there are settings, and also if you have a computer that is a bit older or something, it might be hard to have it running with these trees. But there are actually settings in the menu where you can change the look of the trees, you can remove the animations, and you can kind of fiddle around with it and try and get something that adds some performance in case your computer has a problem running it, and that is always a bonus, right? Okay, so the UI here has definitely had an overhaul, and I can see there's a whole bunch of icons down here that look new to me. But anyway, let's get going. So we are going to be building, and the first thing we're going to add is a storehouse. Did it actually tell me what to do? Yes, place a storehouse and a wooden house. Okay, so that hasn't changed. That is how it usually is. This has been overhauled now, and you can actually see that you can place roads. This was kind of written in very tiny letters before, and people would overlook it, so they didn't know you could place your own roads, but you can. So that's nice. But here we go. We have a storehouse. We need 40 wood, 40 stone, and 100 gold. Allows the storage of resources and items. You can have up to 3 storehouses, and you are gonna need those 3 storehouses because each of them doesn't really store that much. Well, it might have been changed, the stack sizes, but they are linked once you place them, so it's not like you have to run from one to the other. When every time you go into this build mode, you'll be able to see what's in, or have access to everything that's placed in all of them, right? But anyway, let's try and get you placed. And of course now, compared to when I played previously, we also have to worry about actually making our dwarves happy. It kind of was a thing in the past, but it didn't really impact anything, but that has been changed. So now it's really important that you have decorations, that you have sewage access, and that you have water access with all your houses to keep your dwarves happy, and that will impact how they work, so they will work faster or bring in more resources or make better resources and things like that, right? So that also means I'm gonna have to think about how I want to actually place things. Because I have to worry more about making sure all my houses are covered. So we're probably going to end up making these little areas where we have some houses and then all these things that we need to keep them all covered in the middle or something. I don't know. We'll see how it turns out. Because there's also a whole bunch of new decor now that wasn't there last time I played. But I think for now we're going to place our storehouse here because you can move it later. And then we are going to build a wooden house. There's also a stone house, but I think, yeah, we need a stonemason shop for that, which we don't have yet. So we are going to go with a wooden house. Allows 2 citizens to live in basic comfort. Houses are furnished by carpenters. Okay, so we are gonna get this house in. And let's see, how are we gonna do this? Because you can overlap like this with the roads, right? So you can have a road right here and then a house in front. But we're gonna have our dwarves kind of going to and from this. So we'd probably like to have a good access when it comes to workstations. At least some of them we're probably gonna try and place around here. So I'm kind of thinking, okay, for now we're gonna put you over here, I think. So then we can have kind of a workstation here, maybe another one here, and then kind of a road leading into. And well, we could have. How do I want these houses? Of course, it's kind of hard to create what would be a circle. It's gonna be a square, but still. Okay, I think we're gonna put you there. Yes. Oh no, we have to. I always forget about this. We have to call our town something, and I am terrible at making up names, so it's just gonna be my go-to name for this is New Hope. Oh, I need a space somewhere else here, so there we go, New Hope. Did I get a space in there again? Okay, yep, don't know why I'm doing that. So New Hope, confirm, and then we can choose. Every time you put down a house, you're gonna be able to choose two out of a tree, right, dwarves that you want to add. So we have a Vaindra or Valndra. That's probably Valndra, right? Traits grumpy and strong, is always in a worse mood than a typical dwarf. That's probably not so good, because then she will not work as well, I guess. Or she will have a constant debuff, I suspect. But she's strong and can carry more resources, so she would be one. In that case, he's good because he will bring in more wood and stone in the beginning, and we need someone to do manual labor at first. Then we have Hiran, Isiheim, animal lover and slow. Abhors hunting or hurting animals in any way, walks and runs slower than most dwarves, so he's pretty much not very good. Then we have Annan, a sickly and oaf, is more likely to catch an illness, loves doing manual labor of any kind. Okay, of course it's not good that you can catch an illness, but I do like that you like manual labor. So we are gonna go for you, and then I think we're just gonna go with you, even if you're gonna have this potential debuff, because you can still carry more. You have something positive, and you have something positive. So that's what we're gonna go with. Two ladies, confirm. Awesome. And then, of course, we are also gonna want, I think it's over here. Yeah, that's something new as well, that we actually built a mine like this. It used to be right over here somewhere, the mine by default when you started the game. But now you can actually place down mines, which is cool. So there's sewers, but we need a stonemason shop for that. Then we have the stone water well, also needs the stonemason shop. And you can hear they're already busy building. Then we have the core, so we have a wooden lamppost, carpenter shop, stone lamp, ooh, that's stonemason again, and that will add some light plus potential decor, I would suspect. I think there's only those three things you have to worry about. We have rose bushes and apiaries and birch trees and all kinds of other stuff now as well. So if I wanted to make... there's a metalworker shop, which I can actually make right now. Allows the production of copper items, basic potions and tools. But then we would need a second wooden house. What if I want a stonemason? You can see there's a whole bunch of stuff here. Tailor, herbalist, carpenter and so on. So we need more stone, which they're gonna get from me. And then we need more gold, which we're gonna get from either completing quests. Or maybe we can do some shopping. Or sell some stuff, but yeah, we'll see. Let's see what the game tells us to do, right? There we go. Dangerous beginning. Speak with Valndra, the worker, and ask about the activity outside of town. Aha. And of course, for those of you who have seen or played the game before, you'll notice that the houses have a new look now. Look at this. Very cool, and you can actually go inside them, because eventually we're going to be able to decorate them. That is why you can see everything is kind of grayed out right now, but that's because a carpenter is going to furnish this for you. But some of the houses will also sometimes get special decor, potentially out here. in their garden when you do certain quests, and sometimes the reward will be that that dwarf that lives here will then get a new or some kind of new decor. The same thing if your dwarves are happy for, if they are fully happy for a certain amount of time or something. I don't remember the details, but then they will there will be some changes to the house as well. That kind of shows you that anyone who lives there are kind of happy, right? But let's see. First, I want to check. Well, we can press V. So you can see we have a whole lot of jobs here. Right now we have 2 workers. You can even rename them if you want to. What is the compressed geo? Oh, okay, that's like that. But right now it's fine the way it is. I think I kind of like this, at least for now, until we have more people. And right now they're both collecting wood, so I'm gonna change. There we go, just change goal, and then you can see you can switch between wood and stone, but I want you to get some stone, and you get some wood. Cool. Cool, cool. Okay, so we need to, and of course you're the one who's running off to get some stone now. See if I can catch up with you. Here we go. And yes, there we go. Is there something I can help you with? So first of all, about, it kind of tells you their name and what job they have. Then you can change here. If you click this, it's going to change between trees and stone as well. Then there's the quest. This is the perfect spot. This is the perfect spot to build our town, but I saw some goblins to the east. I think they followed us here and they didn't look friendly. Oh dear. Then there's like an info box. I'm not quite sure what that would do when if there was something here. Then there's their mood, which of course is important now. So you can see her like her special traits here, and then you can see she has an I just moved here buff, which is plus 50. And I don't know why it says 86 actually in the parentheses behind. I think that's the total that you have, since it doesn't show anything for the other one. So her total mood is probably 86. And you'll have this for a few days in the beginning. I don't remember if it's 2, 3, or 4 days or something. You'll have this I do just moved here buff. And of course you'll have it whenever you get a new dwarf. They are going to have this. And then she has an I'm happy to be here buff. I don't have access to fresh water, negative. The area around my house is dirty, negative. The area around my house is ugly. So, decor, sewers, and water is what we need. I have a nice house, so she's happy she has somewhere to live. Everything stinks, leave me alone. Yeah, but she's always in a worse mood, so she has a minus 10 debuff by default. I had a beer at the brewery, so that's because we apparently have some beer, because we don't have a brewery, but we do have beer here that we have brought with us, I guess, so eventually we're gonna be able to produce more of this. There are monsters nearby, and of course that's what this is about, so we're gonna have to go and deal with them, and then that will remove this debuff. There we go. So let's let her get back to work, and now it is morning again. Fortunately the days are not, or the nights are not too long, and it doesn't get too dark, so that's a good thing. But let's see if we can find the... Okay, so we have a new minimap deal. We actually have a compass instead of a... I feel like we had a minimap in the past. But that one, as you can see in the top right here, that points at my town, so you can always find your way back. And this would be a quest objective, so that's where we can find some of these goblins. So let's go and see if we can actually deal with them. Then there was another thing, because there's so many things I have to get used to now, because we do have these tools used to chop down trees. Okay, they don't go there. Okay, they can go in here. So we have hatchet and a pickaxe. Lovely. And as you can see, you can wear bracers, shoulders, helm, and there's even trash as well. I guess that's for deleting items. We only have 200 gold left. Wow. Okay. And now we also have new hope with 3 stars. I don't know quite know what that means, if the 3 stars mean anything. But let's see, we should be able to... Well, I kind of like having trees within the border. Ooh, there's someone over there. So let's see. Okay, so it just kind of equips your tool automatically. that is awesome. And it actually picks up your wood now. In the past, we had to run around and pick things up that dropped on the ground. So that's a change as well. As you can hear, there's a lot of changes. So how do I... okay, I just left click and now I have my hammer here again. So let's try and deal with these guys. And there's a little pop-up about fighting. And the combat has been changed as well. So that's probably a bunch of stuff for me to figure out. And this is not really my forte with all this combat. So of course we can dodge. We can block. We can press and hold to attack. That's kind of nice. And hitting a monster does not interrupt its attack. So that's something to keep in mind. But it does seem like sometimes they do. Or at least it used to in the past. But I guess if they're already trying to in the middle of hitting you, then it won't interrupt it. But it can, I think it can still keep them from interrupting if you're attacking them fast enough. Then it doesn't necessarily interrupt that specific attack, but it keeps you keeps them from attacking you. But we'll see if that has changed. Okay, yes, that's a whole bunch of info here. Let's see if we can deal with these guys over here. There's actually only one right now. So... Oh, yes. Huh? Oh, okay, so we got a little hit there, took 13 health points. Oh, we level up, awesome. Okay, let's see what we got. We got some gold, that's a good thing, and we got some leather that we can use for crafting, awesome. And we have gained a new skill point, so if we press X, this is all new again, yeah. Oh, so many things to figure out. So skill points 1, we have a 0 out of 1200 XP. And yes, if you want to unlock new skills or have access to new skills, you have to build up your town. So you can see right now we have one house, the next time we're going to need 4 houses, 6 and so on. But to get skill points to actually spend in here, you have to defeat enemies, of course. But I think you'll also get skill points for doing other stuff like quests and things. But we'll see as we progress. I didn't really notice if we got any skill points earlier when we did a quest though. But I think that's how it works. So we have kick and knocks monsters down. Power attack performs a special attack based on the weapon you're holding. Dash attack, dash forward, deal damage and knock down a monster. Block stamina, reduces the amount of stamina used when blocking. Stamina used when rolling. Reduces the damage from physical attacks. That's probably a good one for me. Lumberjack, chance to get extra quality wood when chopping down a tree. An extra quality stone. Does it mean we can get a higher or better quality, or do we get more of it? It's kind of says a higher quality, right? So I don't know, maybe there are different qualities you can get now, because I don't recall there being anything. Because otherwise it should be quantity, right, if you get more of it. But usually this is not something I do too much. Sometimes I'll help them out if I have enough room in my storehouse and I really want to build something. But for the most part, I want the other dwarves to take care of this. Then we have increased run speed by a small amount. I think I want this one. I'm not very good at these power attacks and all this. Based on the weapon you're holding. Yeah, apparently there's several different of these power attacks now that you can choose between, and I guess you can learn more of them as you progress, right? And then we can kick to knock monsters down. I'm just really bad at all these special attacks. So I think reduce damage from physical attacks is the first thing I want to go for. Which apparently I can't. Why can I not do that? Well, it does say 1 for all of these. But some of these say 1 as well. And it says 2. And some that says 3. What does the numbers mean? Is it because I have to have one other skill in this or in the previous? Like maybe I have to learn something before, or one thing before I can get this. So here I would have to learn 2 other things. Or maybe I have to learn 2 things in here before I can get this. Otherwise I don't understand what the numbers mean, but it looks like the only thing I can do is this one. So I guess we're gonna go for the kick. Aha! So we have to press F to kick. And then of course there's a special attack cooldown. Yep. Okay. Cool. We're gonna have to see when we get another skill point, but I think now that these are actually activated, so maybe we can actually get one of them. Yeah, I think that might be how it works. So we need to find 3 months. Oh, there's something glittering over here. Let's just go and check that out. Oh, and we have bees. Mm-hmm. Oh, we got 5 wheat. Lovely. Okay, and then we have you. Oh, we got our first beehive. Yeah, lovely. Let's see. Okay, so where do I have to go? I have to go this way. Yep. So let's just see if we can deal with these guys quickly. Yep, I see them right down. Oh, there's another one over here. Uh-huh. And if I remember correctly, you can grow trees as well within your camp or something. I don't really fully remember because men are so much new information, right? But I think there's, or maybe not. Am I mixing this up with another game? I just feel like there was a way you can get beehives inside your house or inside your village as well. Well, there's an apiary you can build, of course. But no, never mind. Let's wait and see. Because I was thinking if you can plant trees, then maybe there was a chance that you could get it. But that might be another game I'm thinking about there. So let's try and do this, and then we can kick you like that. Yep. Nice. And let's see if I can figure out how to. There we go. Okay, they did do some damage, even though I was trying to block them. Oh boy. Nice. Uh-huh. Okay, so now we have, we found some copper ore and more leather. Lovely. And of course we have this to use to build apiaries, used by brewers to brew beer. Cool. Lots of stuff to do with that. Wow, it's already getting dark again, but look at the colors. I absolutely love the colors of the sky here. It's so beautiful. So let's just try and take out the last one. Right over here. Ooh, monster spellcasters. So spellcasters have the ability to cast various attack and defense spells. So that's also something new now that they can actually... you can see they're preparing to cast a fireball spell. This one is preparing to cast a lightning spell. They're also not affected by status effect attacks such as knockdowns and stuns, and they can be blocked. But from what I remember, they can actually also buff their friends or something, which is new. Yep, so there's a whole bunch of new things. Okay, I'm curious how it works, because last time I played, when you had a spellcaster attacking you, it was very, very easy to avoid. It didn't really need to do much rolling. Okay, let's just try and deal with you first. Okay, there we go. The other one is coming. So, yeah, there we go. You just have to move out of the way. Which, of course, makes sense. But it is fairly easy to avoid them as long as you keep an eye on them while you're doing other stuff. See? Mm-hmm. There we go. Just keep moving until he does that. And then while he's busy doing that, we can do this. Oh, there we go again. Boom, got you. And quest complete, lovely. Well, we do have, yeah, we're getting some XP now. So quests also give you XP, right? And we're gonna need a bunch of that, so that is cool. Okay, so, something in the storehouse is taking things without permission. Investigated. Oh no, that is not good. That is not good, guys. Oh, so let's hurry back here, because I was actually gonna try and drop off some of all this stuff. Seems like, yeah, we're full on stone and wood, that's why they're just standing around here. They don't really have anything to do right now. Oh, look at that, we have rats in here. You little sneaky gits. No, you are not. Yeah, I'm really, really... Oh, look at this. He actually has a stronger knife. See, it's like it has like this green glow. Oh yeah, so I was taking some good damage there. Well, Nothing in here, but we got some monies. Okay, and now we have a new quest, but let's just... Oh, I keep doing that because I'm used to using E in other games, so I'm probably gonna do that a few times. But and now we can actually move this stuff in there. You can also press... It moves one at a time, but you can also press Shift to move more at a time, right? It looks like it moves 5 and not 10. Yeah, it moves 5 at a time with Shift. Interesting. Then we have some oils as well, which we're probably gonna need later, but for right now I think we can just put it in here. We have some apiaries. Cool. Nice. That was and then I have some wood, but can't really put that in there now. Okay, well, we have some new stuff that of course we need to build and we have to get into that, but we are out of time for this episode, so we're gonna continue that next time, guys. So yeah, let me know what you think of the game and of the changes if you have seen and or played the game before, because there's already a whole bunch of changes that I've already encountered in this episode, which is really, really cool, and I do like what I see. So thank you for watching, guys, and as always, do take care and... Happy gaming!